What's up, guys? Hobbo88 here. Welcome to V8SCOPS. We're at Canadian Tyre Motorsports Park, or Mosport. Two races tonight. This is race number one. We're starting from 25th because we suck at qualifying and choked, basically. So 25 laps, no pit stops required in this race. We'll be starting way back here on the last corner. I can't believe that we've got to start on the corner. But anyway, one of our worst performances so far for the year. But we'll see whether or not we can move forward. It's not going to be easy to pass here, but we'll see. Maybe we get lucky, top 20 or something like that. We'll just hope for the best. Short laps, so should be not much more than half an hour, this one. It's waiting for the lights to pop up. I don't know what we're going to do about starting on the corner. Could be interesting. Hey, man. Waiting till the last second. Here we go. We got away all right.
Safety car.
Oh, that's our first race done. Can't remember if we have to hold position.
Safety car, no passing.
Yeah. That's what happens when you qualify bad, guys.
Brain is what we get.
A lot of cars torn up in that. And I thought that we were going to get through it too. We dodged a few of them, and then that was it. We just got cannoned into.
Andy, you alright, mate?
Yes, sorry. I'm okay.
These cars that have blown up, this is where this system doesn't work. Not being able to overtake.
Can I get an escape?
Sorry, I've got 7 prepared.
Loxton just blew up right in front of me too.
Just hold position for a moment, please.
I'm not allowed to push him, or I get a penalty.
All cars hold position, please. Car 75, you need to redress back to behind car 26.
Alright, both guys are stuck in escape now, please.
How bad is it? 6 minutes.
Jackson, you need to be, make sure you are back behind car 26.
It's going to be a race in the pits. Like, we have to get these done and get out as quick as we can, because there's going to be a lot of cars that are damaged.
Okay, yep. Yeah, I've got him now.
If we beat him out of the pits, we get some spots, so we'll see.
Wayne, if you've got a copy, you can escape too, please.
Thank you. a little bit toe out. Definitely down on power. It's not good. I reckon it'll probably blow up before the end of the race. We hit hard at the front, we got no front end on it at the minute. Not even getting the sixth gear on the straight. Very good, Brian. Complaining about understeer. Yeah, understeer's not an issue anymore on the right-handers. This is my idea of being easy on the motor. He's right though, should be probably coasting it, clutching and stuff. It blows up. Kind of want to push on here a little bit while I've got the clean air. I think I'm just going to come back down the lane when all the leaders catch me and try and get out of their way. I don't want to be cruising around trying to get out of everybody's way too much. So Marlon's back out of the pits just behind me. So salvage mode for race one. I'm interested to see where Marlon cycles through in positions. He crosses the line. If he's 30th, that's good. I don't know how many are out on track behind me. There's one between us. Who is it and how far back are they? Brady. It's a couple of laps behind me still. Accidentally put fuel in it at the pit stop earlier too. Excellent. So I'll try and do two more laps. Hopefully I can two more before the leaders catch me. Come in, repair a few seconds of damage while I wait for the field to go through, and then pop back out. No, definitely not short on fuel. We gained another spot. I mean, it would be more time efficient for me to stay out, but I don't want to be the guy who gets in amongst all the leaders and causes chaos. There's not a lot to gain. Plenty to lose by getting involved. Yeah, I'm not sure. So Michael Barron was the one who I just passed the position. I'm on the same lap as Ross, but I don't know where he is. Hopefully we can get back around without him catching us. Quickly. I think we're just going to get there, alright. Couldn't have timed it better. Sneak in a few repairs while we wait for the field to cycle past. Brent O'Brien in 10th. see where this pops us out. Judge it too well, we could have got out a little quicker. It's not Guinness, but I wish it was. Alien juice. I mean, it could be Guinness. Maybe that's what it is. Hasn't gone well anyway. That's for sure, Brindyman. Safety car.
Safety car. Please stay on track, those drivers who have asked for escape. Safety car.
You might meme a couple of spots back. Surely it's up around the corner here in the same spot.
Hold position, Jacob, between car 1 and car 117.
So it should be another couple of freebies. We're going to end up finishing better than where we qualified if we keep this up. It feels like that race at Sydney for the finale of the V8 Supercars a few years ago when it was a championship.
Robbie Preston, you may now escape.
Everyone had to race out of the pits to win the championship. You guys remember that?
Jordan Ross, you may now escape. Thank you. Car 024, you may now park the car in front and safety car. Give way, please.
How many laps down am I? Four. So yeah, I'm not under threat of not making minimum laps. Surely this will be better for the engine than even low RPM.
No, Lee, the ruling is two laps or more down would move across and go backwards, and anybody that is between the leader and the safety car. And the car that we pushed out came out of the pits behind the safety car before the leader had crossed the line.
I think it'll be about 20th. Just a few spots further forward, I reckon.
So does he have to go to the back, or?
No, he does not. He must be two laps or more down on the lead cars to be moved aside and to be moved to the back of the lap cars, the front of the lap cars. He stays in position and regains race. Jared Filsell is the leader of the race. Racing will resume this lap. Safety car to move away from the field. Jared is to maintain pace of the safety car at this pace and will resume racing. No cars are to overlap before the apex of the last corner, and you're not to pass any car in front before crossing the start-finish line.
What just happened to Corey?
All right, Adam, I'll work him on.
I don't know.
Pit lane's open. Pit lane exit is open.
Hey, Kay Brown. 12 months. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. I'll be pretty unhappy if we get a penalty. Gonna let them both go. They're both quicker than me. It's like Corey just elected to go to the rear on his own. Didn't tell anybody, unless I didn't hear it. That was so bad. So still a lap up on Brady, two laps up on Marlon. Yeah, get the emotes happening. Much to cheer about though, is there?
Sorry.
So no other stragglers at this stage that we could try and pass. Hey, thanks for the follow, Tommy. Appreciate it, man. Well, I've been better, Kay Brown. I'm on struggle street right here, just trying to limp to the finish and score points. I mean, a 26th here is actually not awful if we can hang on to it. And then we can still, if we still get a good result in race two, you know, if we were to get a top 15 in race two, and might work out to be a top 20 in points for the round, which would actually be pretty good still. Disappointing, but I mean, we're just lucky so many cars got taken out when they did in that lap one crash, and that we've been able to get out of the pits ahead of most of them.
Right, so what do you have?
Use a couple more to blow up, but they'll have to do it soon. In fact, they'd really have to do it right now, or else we're not going to get them before the end anyway. I'm not sure what lap the leaders are on, but might be too late for that anyway. Oh, Oh, that car looks like it's evil. Must not have a meatball. Would have liked him to come into pits that lap and stay there. Would have been a top 25. This car looks about as bad as mine. We're too far back to make any gains on anyone now, unless Ross has a problem. Almost spun out right there. It's a little taily on the left-handers. So the leaders have started their last lap, we just need to make it around one more time. I mean, we started in, what, 25th, was it? We're going to end up getting to the finish in 26th, so all things considered, can't complain too much about that, although I do feel like we should not have been starting that far back in the first place, so not the result that I was looking for, but we've salvaged something just by limping to the finish. If you are still watching this one back on YouTube, you've done well. Thanks for tuning in, I hope you enjoyed it. Follow me on Twitter at Hobbo88, twitch.tv/Hobbo88 for the live streams. We'll be back for race number two. Hopefully, we can salvage something a little bit better. Here we go, guys, race two. 39 laps this time, and we start from 20th. Again, we completely stuffed our quali, but at least we're a few spots forward to where we were last race. Fingers crossed we don't get into any carnage here on the first lap this time around. We will see. Oh, better start the car. That was almost catastrophic. So 39 laps, we will have to make a pit stop. Right, here we go. Weird, I got a default spotter there for a second. I tried to go around me on both sides. That was scary. We survived. Massive checkup right in the middle of the corner there. It's a little blinded, nearly ran straight in the back of Marlin. Go. just feel like something's going to happen up here with these guys in front of me. They're going to... Something's going to happen, I think.
Thing here, excuse me, I bet I'm going to go.
That was a bit dodgy by Ian. Hey, thanks for the follow. Yeah, I prefer the Holden, just the Holden, man. That's why. No reason otherwise. They're the same car. Yeah, that's it, Accenture. They're identical cars.
You're wrong. Let's go try and look at that.
That's all your fault. Just drive, guys. We'll look at it.
Straight off. Jeez, Lee left me no room there, that was brave. I knew I'd do that once in this race. So we got it out of the way early. is in very early. I just need to stop overdriving it, that's all, Coxy. Car's actually not bad, I just keep making mistakes. Hey, thanks for the host, Boyd. Appreciate it, man. Good man. Touch a little bit with those guys in front of us. Oh, not again. Oh, Jesus. I'm not getting involved in that. Not with him. Ah, not what I wanted. Oh, we're gonna get done for speeding? I don't know how. Poor boy. I feel like I'm just under-fueled. Corey, I think maybe, did Corey get a speeding penalty? Dunno. Dunno, we'll see how it shakes out. No, we're just just had a quicker stop than Corey, that's all. I wasn't expecting him to put two wheels in the grass to get past, or go off track to get past. Just a one stop, we go to the end from here. Short on fuel, but I think it'll come back to us as the tyres wear off. If we get up behind some of these guys, we might be able to save a little bit too. is all super awkward around there, so I don't want to be near it. Just brings the guys behind us all up to us, which we don't want. Hey Aussie, how are you, man?
Car number 52, Thomas Hintz, you have a pit lane penalty. You must serve this lap. You've been PM. Do not serve this lap. You'll get an in-game 30-second hole penalty. Car number 52, Thomas Hintz.
Good man, send it. I just don't, the thing is that Chris and Ethan have both got fresher tyres than me and they'll drive away, but Wayne has got older tyres and he's just driving defensive and slowing us all down. But I mean, I kind of just want to let them sort themselves out. I don't want to get involved. The other car with big speed at the minute is Ian Ford. He's got fresh tyres too. Hey Rubes. Yeah, but there's no point doing a big dive bomb taking people out. Real happy with Ian in this race. Man, what am I meant to do there? I knew he was going to do it well before he did it. Twice though he's tried to pull that move, or once that he has pulled it, the other time he tried to. Yeah, well that's going to be a drama when that happens too. Yeah, I'm hoping that Ian takes him out. Lee was going to kill me there. Crash written all over it. Berkey's a cork at the minute. Slowing us down so much. Being at the back of this. Whoop. Hopefully that doesn't cost us at the end of the straight. Now I'm the one who's got to deal with Berkey, which isn't what I wanted either.
It's okay, man.
He's an extremely aggressive defender. The problem is the way that he defends, there's an 80% chance if I get the move done that I'll get a penalty. It's just like, how aggressive do you really want to be? Laps we got to go. he doesn't need to pit.
Are you with it? Thank you, my friend. Permission to escape. Yeah, you're right, mate. You're safe.
Tires a couple of laps to cool off. Working pretty hard. Sounds like it. Might actually be going to let me have it. Might be low on fuel. Scrappy lap. I like my Fanatec gear. It's an upgrade from Logitech setup. Three up ahead are having a good little battle. I reckon Berkey will try and send it back on me here towards the end.
Hold please, Lee. Safety car, safety car, safety car.
Interesting. Interesting indeed. Late race safety car. Probably not what I wanted. I've got older tyres than most.
Safety car, safety car.
Cue another massive accident here towards the end.
Can you please deploy over attack, Chad?
Our fuel woes out of being a factor now, which is interesting.
We are under safety car conditions, please, gentlemen. Safety car, safety car, safety car.
Make it interesting.
Hold please, Lee.
Riley Preston just passed me under yellow flag.
Wonder if we'll get memed out of this race here in the last couple of laps. Everyone will be going hell for leather.
Car 055, Riley Preston, you need to move behind David Sanford.
Yeah, mate.
Car 071.
Nah, no pit stop. not with three laps to go. I imagine the safety car will be in at the next time by, and it'll be three laps to the finish.
Pit lane's closed, pit lane's closed.
So there's a good chance if we don't get punted.
Okay, Lee, you can escape now, thank you.
And we don't get shuffled out of line here on the restart.
Pit exit is open.
It's a good chance that a couple of people in front of us will have a drama and we may be able to steal the top 10. Just depends. Webster looks fast. We know Preston's aggressive and Berkey, one of the more aggressive drivers in the field as well. We'd be surprised if one of them tries to move me.
Safety car lights are off. Safety car moving away from the pack. Jared Filsell has the lead of the race. There is to be no overlapping before the apex of the last corner. No passing before the start finish line.
Doing a very good job of holding, maintaining a speed, aren't they? They're all over the place. Behind us. You're nervous. We got older tyres than most people too, so we're disadvantaged here. We're black flagged. Is our race done? That was pretty bad. Well, needless to say, I'm not very happy with that. This whole round of V8SCOPS has turned out to be a waste of time, more or less. We'll have to box this time or else we get disqualified if we don't. So that's our race finished. If you tuned in on YouTube, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Follow me on Twitter at Hobbo88, twitch.tv/Hobbo88 for the live streams. Don't forget to tune into the Discord channel. Link is in the description below. But that's it for this video, guys.
I didn't mean to do that, Brian.
See you in the next one.